The Houben family is one of the lineages with the longest trajectory and history in the world of pigeon sport. They are located in the town of Uitgem, very close to the Belgian city of Antwerp. Jef, its leader, his wife Evelien, their two children, Luc and Nadia, and their spouses, as well as Jef's niece, Cindy, have been responsible over the years for maintaining the name of this spectacular pigeon loft. Before Jef, his grandfather and father were also fanciers. We are therefore talking about one of the oldest lineages in Europe. The beginnings with Belder. Jef's father, Gerard, had been breeding pigeons since 1920. But, despite his great enthusiasm, he never achieved great success. He was best known for his ability to build excellent breeding lofts rather than for his pigeon flying skills. If this was so, the question arises as to why then the Houbens have been so important in the history of Belgian pigeon racing. The answer is that Gerard married the daughter of a heavyweight in the pigeon world, Belder. Therefore, we have that Jef's grandfather, on his mother's side, was Maud de Belder, who owned the largest pigeon-based pigeon colony of Van Sulemans de Berlaar. For pigeon fanciers, it should be noted that the famous line of pigeons of the Jansen brothers from Arendonk were awarded by this same Van Sulemans. It is here that we see the importance of the Houben family and the connection with Belder, owner of the pigeons of Van Sulemans' origin. From the time Jef was a child, he showed real skills in poultry breeding. He spent hours and hours with his grandfather, from whom he learned every last detail of this incredible world. Gradually he took on more and more responsibility in his father's breeding loft and in his last days of life. He was proud to have kept his breeding pair, Jong Artist and Sissy, which dated back to the Sulegmans pigeons, with more than 50 years of history inherited from his grandfather's breeding law. Also, the introduction of the last pigeons of his friends Stan Raymakers, Franz Stosses, Albert Everaerts, and some changes he made with Carol Hufkins, Joes van Loo, Joes Thone, and Gamer Verbruggen, contributed to the creation of the great Houben lineage. Not all the pigeons introduced gave great competitors. Therefore, each newly introduced bird was tested with great care before it became part of the Houben breeding line. Luc and Nadia Houben. In the 1950s, Jef Houben's two children, Luc and Nadia, began to take an interest in the loft that had seen them grow up. Just as his grandfather had done with him, Jef also instilled in his two children a love for the sport and a constant dedication to the pigeons in order to obtain good results. Such was the passion and motivation for this world. At the beginning, Jef only competed in speed flying, and over the years, with dedication and hard work, the Houben family's activity has focused on medium and long distance flying. Jef was a man true to his principles and passionate about the sport. Just before his death, he was still an active member of the first club he joined, De Wippen Uitgem, organizer of the Quirijn and Nooyen races. Jef had already won 12 first places in 1951, and in 1958 he became the champion of his Uitgem club. During the 1960s, he began to focus on middle distance flying, resulting in 1966 in second place in the AS Paloma provincial middle distance race in the province of Antwerp, among many other championships won. In the 1970s, Houben went from being the king of speed flying to being the champion of long-distance flying. The year 1975 was one of the most successful years of his career, winning 16 first positions in different races. During this period, his bird, Young Baron, was first provincial and eighth national AS pigeon in the cross-country category. At the same time, he also placed first national AS pigeon in the junior category, a title awarded by the prestigious magazine De Belgische Divensport. The loft. The competitive superiority of the Houben family became so obvious and uncomfortable that even the most powerful fanciers in the province of Antwerp, fearing to lose their birds, excluded the Houben family from some of the medium and long distance flights. What many might interpret as flattery, for Houben was a real disappointment. As he found himself with the loft divided in two, the racing pigeons and the breeding pigeons, and without the possibility to compete at provincial level. The number of pigeons in this breeding loft, during the summer months, was about 350, structured as follows: about 50 pairs of breeders, about 50 widowed males and their females, and about 150 young pigeons. Some of the best fledglings were mated in inbreeding, but before that, the method used was the cross-mating of the lines of all good competitors. Competitions and the working system. The Albans' favorite races were those ranging from 350 to 800 kilometers. The adult pigeons were flown on the widowhood system, which consisted of the following. All the pigeons were mated in November or December, and then the males were separated after the weaning of the first batch of young pigeons, and in April, mated again. Only the males took part in the races. The second and third batches of young birds were flown using the dark system. Most of the young birds flew as celibates while the other two categories flew as normal. The widowers, for example, were trained for 1 hour in the morning and 1 hour in the afternoon, allowing them to fly at will around the loft. At the beginning of the season they were put into baskets and trained by gradually increasing distances. The first race took place in mid-April in the first national race in Bourges, 480 kilometers, at the end of May. Before this major competition, the birds were trained twice in flights of 110 kilometers, 220 kilometers and 350 kilometers, weather permitting. The young pigeons were also trained twice a day for 1 hour and then basketed and trained at distances of 1x5 kilometers, 1x10 kilometers, twice at 20 kilometers, twice at 40 kilometers and twice at 60 kilometers. The Albans trained both in their own loft and at the official clubs. At the beginning of the season, the adult pigeons were divided into two groups. Some raced over distances between 320 and 480 kilometers, others between 480 and 800 kilometers. With the yearlings, a very similar system was used. One group raced over distances between 320 and 480 kilometers, while the others raced over distances between 480 and 640 kilometers. The young pigeons were separated into two groups, males and females, and raced over distances of up to 480 kilometers. Only some of the yearlings were raced up to 640 kilometers. In conclusion, we could say that the Alban lineage has gone down in the history of pigeon racing as one of the lofts that has won the most prizes, and in part, it has been thanks to its most prized pigeon, the Jong Artist. In almost all the Alban winners and AS of the last few years, you can find his blood in almost all of them. It is arguably this bird that made Alban the icon he is today. Their best pigeon. Reproducing wisely, they noticed that their best breeder of all times was Young Artist, but when it comes to flying, they will name among the very best Sonny, Young Capitaine, Robin, Monaco, Angelo, Herbie, Lincoln, and many others. More than 40 years of successes in pigeon sport did not change Jef, who is the same normal person who practices a sport. He is open to any person who visits him or asks for advice concerning pigeons. Always next to him, his wife Evelyn is full of life and ready to pamper all those who visit their home and breeding loft. Together with the rest of the family, they always have known how to adapt to changing conditions in this sport. They are never ignored when they participate in race. Considered masters of this sport, they own a breeding loft which is not only one of the best in Antwerp province and Belgium, but in all Europe. Thank you for watching. Until next time.